Ladies and gentlemen, introducing these two Super Fight Series warriors once again. The challenger standing in the blue corner. He weighed in at 76.9 kilograms. He has a record of 15 wins, 3 losses and 2 draws. He represents KO Next Generation from Portugal. Wilton, the Black Panther, Barros. And standing across the ring in the red corner, he is the reigning, defending WKA European Champion. He weighed in at 76.6 kilograms. He has a record of 9 wins with 3 losses and represents the Combat Academy. He is Nick Samways!
It's big, big title fight time. The WKA European title defense for Nick Samways from the Combat Academy as he takes on the Black Panther, Wilco Barros from KO Next Generation. Crew Sam in his corner there, and we've seen many of Wilco's fights as we have Nick Samways. On paper, this is explosive, Chris.
Nick Samways is the complete fighter. He's the champ for a reason. A really skillful guy in all departments. That being said, Wilco Barros has been on a meteoric rise. He fights out of a very forward-thinking gym and brings a lot of unique tools to the table. How is it going to go down? We're going to find out right now. 5 rounds, if necessary, here tonight at 76 kilograms. We are underway, coming to you live from the Albin Arena.
Yes, and Samways, alongside that technical ability, unbelievable raw power as well when he needs it, Chris.
So a little bit of a feeling out process thus far. For Barros, the strategy, I think, is going to be either in or out. He doesn't want to sort of allow Samways to get comfortable and exchange with a fighter who may have a slight edge in the reach department and, of course, a really strong kicking game as well.
That's right. Samways, the taller of the two men. As I said, he's an absolute powerhouse as well. But Wilco Barros, we've seen before, very good, very technical, very accurate as well. And you're right, he either has to be all the way in throwing the shots and then back out and look to outsmart Nick Samways and maybe just be that little bit faster with his technique, Chris.
You can already see that tie hop from Nick. Really light on that lead leg. He fights very technically correct.
And I agree with you. I think with the importance of this, the European title and the defense at stake, these two men know it's 5 rounds. They're very, very seasoned professionals. They'll work their way into this. There's the fast hands that I told you of Wilco Barros.
The one thing that we've seen from Wilco is that he's really good at evolving and reading his opponent. So I expected a slightly more patient start from both guys. We've got a lot of time to go here tonight.
What I like that I've already seen from Wilco is the way he's ready to stay in the pocket with Nick to lure the lead and then watch him counter sharply when that right leg came around from Nick Samways. Wilco really got the fast punching combination. Here you go, look, he immediately replies to stop a powerful man getting a real rhythm going.
He's also really good at coming in, throwing some shots, and then exiting to reset. He doesn't want to be there for Nick to counter. Samways, a ton of power. We've seen some really nice kicks so far from him. And a nice lead push kick there, that teep. Cross check there from Samways, really nice.
For me, the thing here is when Samways gets in a groove like this, if Wilco can get out of the way or take his power, one or the other, because the last thing you want is Nick Samways on a roll throwing the heavy shots at you. Wilco is capable of keeping that focus. We've seen it so many times. And he's slick as well.
The stance swapping from Barros has been a really, really intelligent approach so far. Samways is really strong at reading you and capturing you in and out of position. He was trying to do that, but Barros was smart. He was in, he was out. He changed lead foot position. Great round between both guys.
I agree, Chris. It was a good feeling out round, and I really felt that Barros did the right thing, because when Samways is on that sort of roll, is when you've got to worry. But Wilker made sure, after watching the full round, that didn't happen that often. In fact, he may have even taken the sting out of that round and pushed it in his favor.
So here we go, a little bit more on that action throughout the round. Barrow switching up, landing that left kick to the body, a glancing blow, and then actually stepping backwards to avoid the counter. Really smart. This fight could come down to how both guys anticipate each other's responses and, of course, their game plans.
For me, one of the keys, Chris, will be the simple fact that if Nick Samways manages to land hard and clean, how Wilker will adapt or manage it, because there will come a point when he's going to be asked a big question from this powerhouse hitter. But at the moment, Wilker, sharp and fast and focused.
Nice counter there, though, from Samways, really chopping into that low kick.
For me, he's your worst nightmare. You've either gifted with incredible power or great technique, but when you've got a man that's got exceptional technique and power, that is the most dangerous of fighters.
Nice counter again there from Samways. The moment that Wilker thought about coming in for a kick, Samways' response. Wilker did land a nice knee there, though. There was a knee about 30 seconds ago. He's got a great game in the clinch. We've seen him fight Muay Thai before. And, of course, with that game comes the knee. So if he can look to try to land those from outside here, being under the K-1 rule set, you're not allowed to clinch as you can in Muay Thai, it could be an effective weapon.
Well, both men are playing the same game here at the moment. That's what makes this so intriguing. Neither wants the other to get the rhythm up. As soon as Wilker comes in and starts to blast, Nick is looking immediately for the reaction and vice versa. So when the action comes, it's technical, it's fast, and there's the left hook from Samways. Now it's beginning to pick up, Chris.
Look at that, though. It's just beautiful Muay Thai technique. Multiple punches and a kick for Samways. Barrows resets, stutter step to an outside round kick. He did throw the knee a couple of times, landed two knees. I want to see more of that from Barrows. Fast hands, get inside, land the knee, and then exit. Don't sit here and exchange kicks, because Samways is nasty with those. That being said, good combinations there from Wilker Barrows.
This is the thing that surprised me. For the first time in the bout so far, someone managed to land without anything coming back, and that was Wilker this time. Previously to that, Chris, it's tit for tat like we saw there, and I think this is going to be the key. If it goes the distance, this is going to be the key. Because Wilker is so switched on at the moment against such a dangerous opponent that he's getting his work off, waiting for... Oh, cheek to the face, Chris.
Considered disrespectful in traditional Muay Thai. Barrows lands that one perfect. Samways looking to turn it on now. This is the thing that really is so intriguing to me about this matchup, is both guys are big, both guys have got power, but they've also got that speed.
Well, for me, as I said, it's who's getting their combinations off and not getting the replies. And what Wilker's done well is just a little bit of variety to keep Nicky on that back foot as he did there. And when you're on the back foot, it's harder to spring straight back. As you said, he comes in nice, he comes in fast, but I like the way he retreats as well, which is so important. But when he disengages, Nicky's got to reset again.
Wilker mixing things up a little bit more now. I would have thought this would have been the strategy. In or out, keep Samways guessing.
And you see the way he sprung forward there. That was simply because he doesn't want his back to the ropes. Have you noticed how Wilker is avoiding having his back to the ropes with Samways in front of you?
Great fight. This is everything we'd expected here. It's a European title. The silverware is on the line, and both guys have clearly come very well prepared with an understanding of their opponent.
Exactly. It's clean, it's technical, and it's very clever from both men. And what I like is 90% of the time, Chris, it's tit for tat. You won't get a rhythm going. You throw a strike, and then when it comes back, you're ready for it.
That's exactly what Wilker did just there. He landed a nice connection, backed off against Samwell, and actually before was looking to set up, realized Samwell was going to counter, and then backed off. Wilker sets up, then gets in and out on his terms. That's going to be his key to victory in this fight. Samwell's really tough. He's got a lot of power. The Black Panther needs to outfox the champion.
Start drawing him down a bit.
Nick Samways, excuse me.
That's the key for me, Chris, is the fact that Wilker, his key to victory is getting in and getting out and getting those combinations unanswered. There's got to come a time for me when Nick Samways really tries to keep Wilker Barrows under pressure and keep him there with his back to the ropes. It's got to come at some point during this bout.
So three of a scheduled four here. Three of a scheduled five.
And Wilco clinches up and throws the knee and is pulled away by Paul Nichols, our referee. Both men remaining calm and composed, top of their game, European title at stake. And I'm waiting for that moment, Chris, when Nick Samway gets here, stays here, and then starts to ask questions of Wilco. If that is, Wilco will allow him. That's the great thing about this bout.
Good connection there from Samways.
Solid left hook to the body from Samways. The crowd responds. He's brought a big crowd here tonight. And then Wilco comes in, looks for the little hand combinations and then the knee on top. And for me, this key point in the back, Chris, he's still doing just that bit more than the champion.
This has been a very technical bout. This has been a game of cat and mouse in some ways. Both guys are chasing each other around, backing off, looking to try and find favorable trades. This has been a better round, though, so far for Samways than the last one.
He's starting to try and ask questions of Wilco Barish. He's starting to walk him down. He likes the idea of his back to up. So here's where he wants him to be. You absorb that power when you're in the corner. Like that. There's nowhere to go. Wilco has done a good job of not being in there for too long across this whole bout so far. But you just get the feeling that Samways is now in stalking mode.
Nice switch kick from Barros. That switch hitting worked really well for him in the first, better in the second. I want to see more of it now. We're over the midway point of this round. You look for one guy to really assert their authority here. Right now, I think that's Samways.
Yes, he's certainly trying that here in the third, Chris. He's subtly trying to walk Wilco down. But still, Wilco unhurt, not really been caught by a big shot yet.
There's not a lot of feinting and faking from Samways, whereas Wilker's all over the place. He actually rolled his head back, showed the leg kick, tried to force a reaction from Samways. Samways a little bit more direct. It works. He's got power, he's got reach, he's got brilliant combinations. I'd like to see some more volume. Force Wilco out of his own rhythm.
That's right. And Wilco, though, is buzzing around him, busy and accurate, and not being allowed to be tagged. And again, nice turn there. He did not want his back against the ropes. And that's what we're on about, as the crowd really tried to get behind Samways now. And again, Nick Samways beginning to try and walk more consistently, Wilco Barish down. And for me, the key, if Wilco's going to win this, is how long he can prevent that happening. How long he can stay in the center of the ring and not be under that pressure.
Good couple of punches there from Samways. Just a few seconds left here in this round. He finishes strong here. That could be key.
You're right. It's that close. It's that intriguing. I feel Wilco Barish, his tactical appraisal here is right. He goes in, he stings, he moves. When he feels his back to the ropes, he spins quickly to get back out there. But I felt, I don't know if you did as well, that across that whole third round, Nick was beginning to walk down, getting closer, beginning to let the punches throw. Wilco, as I said, his game plan is simple. Keep it in the second, sting and move. That's hard over five rounds. And you felt that Nick Samway was looking for more and more of those clashes against the ropes.
Samway's did a great job of sort of corralling Barros into his power, controlling the ring. With better fight IQ, it was enough to edge it on my unofficial scorecard here, but look, we've got a couple of rounds left here. Everything to play for, possibly.
Yes, intriguing contest between two top quality men.
So the fourth frame here for this European title, Chris Hoekstra on the call, alongside Malcolm Martin. Our partner is always working with you folks tuning in. The Albin Arena is alive tonight for the Super Fight Series. And what an instant classic we have had between Barros and Samways.
Yes, it's so delicately poised here. You can feel the tension racking up. You can feel the two men stepping up the pace. And as I said, all credit to him. Wilco will know Nick Samway's reputation. You'll see it, the power. And he's dealt with it well so far, but as he did in the third, there's a sense of urgency now about Samways in the fourth, Chris.
We're in the championship rounds right now. Samways putting Barros on the back foot, connects with a low kick, double time, switching up to the midsection.
Barros recognizes it, comes off the ropes back into the middle of the ring. For me, the key for Nick Samways is keeping him there, because that's the power. Beautiful side slip from Wilker, but he needed it. Little right hand and knee from Wilker, and Crew Sam, one of the best in the business there, as we know, Chris. A big cheer as Wilker caught Nick on the way in.
Good connection there from Barros with that left kick. Samways digging there to the liver with that hook.
He's got a very mobile opponent, Chris, and he's looking to slow him down. Now, you can do that with the chopping kicks to the legs, or you can do that with those vicious body shots. And for me, honestly, Nick Samways is getting closer and closer to his challenger.
Drew Sam is calling for more pressure from Barros. It's worth noting that over there at KO Next Generation, they really train their fighters in some unique ways. They respect, quote-unquote, the traditions of Muay Thai, but they like to try to think outside the box, and that really speaks volumes about the sort of different and funky style that Barros brings in. He brings different looks. That being said, though, Nick Samways wants to retain the crown and needs to continue to pour on those power shots that made the last frame successful. It's been a better round for Barros.
I believe that Crew Sam feels that the key for Barros here is to keep Nick Samways from getting up a rhythm, getting up a rhythm like this and getting those power shots going. And every time Wilker has managed to do this, stop the rhythm and starts to move again. But Samways has started to become the relentless beast that we know he is. And this is why the crowd's responding.
Samways has done well to chase Barros down, because when he chases Barros, he really kind of takes him out of his game a little bit more than if Barros is able to dictate the exchanges. It's all about who leads with it.
And as I said, Wilker, just for the first time in this bout, not quite so sharp at countering and moving. He's still doing it, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying it stopped, but it wasn't as sharp as we saw. Rounds one and two were textbook perfect for Wilker. Nick's punches are beginning to have an effect now, as you'd expect they would. And that's not a criticism of Wilker either.
Well, Samways able to really find Wilker's headspace with a bit more efficiency and kind of trapping, using the geometry in a squared circle here. You've got to be mindful of your movement, which is something that Barros does very well. Samways started to take that away from him from the third onwards. May have won in that last round. That was closer than the third, in my opinion, though.
Yes, good call, Chris. I mean, what Nick Samways has done as the third and fourth have gone on is try to walk Wilker down and then land the power shots. He had a superb body shot that slowed Wilker down, and in the previous rounds, Wilker's comebacks were sharp, snappy, and made Nick Samways have to set once again. I found Nick got more and more into the round and threw more heavy leather. It is intriguing. Now, with the fifth and final round, I think Nick Samways will really have to go for broke here to ensure retaining his title.
Well, we are set for the final rounds here tonight, and a European title on the line.
So fifth and final round, and I feel Nick Samway will look to pour on the heat. For me, Chris, it's how Wilker Barros deals with it. If Wilker deals with this well and takes this round, we could have a new champion. But I did tell you, Samway will load up on the power now. He knows that the best way to retain his title is a stoppage.
Samway is pouring on the gasoline here, forcing Barros backwards. Barros pivots. He needs to hand fight. They're trying to get away here from the corner.
This is where he doesn't want to be. This is where Nick's wanted him all evening, to pour on that power. And again, even when you're mobile and you're blocking, as Wilker is, that power is absorbed at a certain level all the time. Whether it's on the arms or the shoulders, you're still absorbing immense power from this man.
Samway's got to keep kicking here. Barros is covering. Some of those shots aren't landing as flush as they could. If he kicks, the legs are wide open.
Yes, and Nick Samways walking him down now. Wilker, for the first time, spending most of the round with his back to the rope, but he doesn't want to be against the corner post as well, where he absorbed the full power. Samway just walking forward now. Wilker beginning to feel the pressure after four mobile rounds of counter fighting. He's now reduced to defense like this.
This is a championship performance from the Samways team here. Nick Samways knows that really this round is key. He's going out there and really put a stamp of authority in signature fashion.
You saw that there when Wilker looked to respond. almost with disdain, he threw him backwards to get these big shots going. He just pushed him away and put the bombs in the game. He's gone up a real gear here, and Wilker in survival mode this fifth round after doing so well for four. He's now learning what the reputation of Nick Samway is for this raw power.
Samway is pulling the trigger beautifully here, finishing with power shots, either that right cross or the left hook. Starting to put the strings together as we race towards the finish line here tonight.
Definitely a round for the champion here, Wilker. Very little coming back now. And even with the guard up, these shots are beginning to get through. He's just beginning to dismantle an incredibly brave challenger. But he is on the rocks now, Chris.
Drew Sam has got the title in his hands. If Samways can get a count here, this would be huge. That would all but guarantee him a win, in my opinion.
And he knows that he's going for the finish here, Samways. Wilker somehow still on his feet. But a mini Superman punch there from Samway, just walking his man back down. And Wilker, the snap has gone from his work now. Tired and hurt, looking to hang on. And Samway then, the right leg on the end of the hand combination. Wilker Barosz is all over the place, and the crowd know it. And Samway pours on the heat, Chris.
Samway's cruising towards the finish line. We go the distance tonight in the Super Fight Series for the WKA European title.
No doubt in the fifth round, it'll be intriguing how the judges scored the first three in my book. Because technically, Wilker Barosz didn't get a count in that book. He wins the first three, he still takes the title. Now the crowd have gone ballistic because of one huge round. But that huge round did not include a count, and this could be vital.
Yeah, the big question is with a bunch of 10-9s probably coming in throughout the five rounds that we saw here tonight, which of these guys won that three rounds or more to take this? I would expect that every single round was scored 10-9. We're gonna find out in a second. They're taking some time to do the mathematics here and double check everything.
That's right, Chris, this is delicately poised. There's no doubt about Samways in that fifth round. The fifth round was definitely the champions. Round four was possibly the champions as well, but it's how you score those first three. Either way, Chris, after an incredible title bout, I'm gonna go in there and get a chat with the winner once the decision's announced.
Here's Grant Waterman with the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five incredible rounds of Super Fight Series Championship kickboxing action, we go to the judges' scorecards. And we have a unanimous decision in favor of your winner. And still, WK.
Tonight, what an incredible fight. Here's Malcolm Martin with the interview.
I'm here with your winner, Nick Samways. And Nick, you are still the European champion, but what a challenge, what a challenger.
Yeah, thank you for the barrels. Great fire.
I want to pick you up on that because we know about your power. We've seen your showcase reel for the knockouts, but you are also, as you proved tonight, a very technical fighter as well.
Yeah, I knew that could be tactics. I come in from boxing, try time things, kick me up into knees, so I had to be careful rushing in to have time.
I agree with that, and it was a very close technical fight. But that showed, because when the fifth round came, the Nick Samways that people know of, the power, you walked Wilker down and you stayed in the pocket for the fifth and final, and really started to unravel.
That's what I love. I love you coming. Just doing spectacular points. Those big cracks for me. Just got to put on a bit. Best fight, best war, that's what people want to see. So.
Well, Nick, you were really tested. tested tonight and you came through like the true champion you are, he's still the European champion, Nick Samuels.